The first game has just started. I'm gonna sort of talk out loud through it and just jump in when you are ready. How about that?
Yep, sounds good.
Cool. So, this board, they're both here. They're ready to play Dominion. What's happening? Well, there's Mountebank. That's always a big stinking deal, but Lighthouse helps. I don't see any way to thin. So, like, that's a big deal. Save and Lighthouse together can provide you with good coverage, so that's probably going to be very important. All the components are here, though. Hunting Party is great for these decks with no trashing. You can really filter past all those starter cards that are bad. And then there's Grand Market and Conspirator, which is super great. Traveling Fair for reliability. So there's this big deck here, and I think Lighthouse coverage is very important in the early game. Lighthouse should help you get up to Grand Markets. Trying to think of, like, maybe you don't want to go for Mountebank. You should probably get a Mountebank. I don't know. It's tough. It really depends because the $2 are still pretty good. Conspirators are fine. Hunting Party Conspirator. This is tough. This is a tough board. With a 4-3, it's tempting to, like, try top decking a Lighthouse or something, but. Yeah, Hugo's background is weird. I don't know what's up with that.
Does it keep going in and out?
No, it's just a solid color for me. I don't usually see anything. Just looks strange.
Yeah. So on mine, it was going in and out. There we go.
Oh,
It's
there
there
it
now.
is. Interesting. I
So I
have
don't
no
know.
idea what's up with that.
I wonder if it's a him problem or if it's a making fun
I
bug.
mean, it's really easy to blame things on making fun, let's be honest.
Well, that's very true.
On a 4-3, you can't, like, open Mountebank, which I would probably do on a 3-4. I would probably open nothing Mountebank on a 3-4. I don't think I can get away from that. That's what his opponent does.
Oh, saving the copper.
Yeah, just because, like, you really want to get some purples in. The Mountebank's not a bad card. There's really very few terminals you want here. It's like you might as well give yourself the chance to get that junk in before they get their coverage up.
Yeah, especially because there's just not. I mean,
Like,
with no trashing, it's just not fun
yeah,
to get out of a mountebank hole.
in fact, like, I would have, after seeing my opponent open save, like Hugo did. Or I guess he had a lucky 5-2. Like, after seeing that, I probably would have turned one Traveling Fair top decked a Lighthouse just to get that coverage up immediately. Like, you can continue to hit four and top deck Lighthouses for a minute, and that seems good.
Yeah.
You can start hitting five, get a Mountebank, and get a Grand Market from there, like, with perfect coverage. And now Hugo's got a purple in his deck.
Yeah.
So. Well, he's got a Lighthouse next hand. Let's see if he picks up his own Mountebank. I think he should. Deidre has zero Lighthouses.
I think I'd maybe top deck a lighthouse here. Oh wait, or Deidre is the one with the lighthouse.
Wait a second. Hugo didn't get any Lighthouses.
I'd definitely top deck a lighthouse here then.
Yeah, Lighthouse seems very important. I'm surprised that I mean, like, I'd be getting a Lighthouse pretty much every turn
Yeah,
if
I
I
would have
could.
opened easily with one.
Looks like the background is in when it's Hugo's turn, or not. Okay, never mind.
No, it was just going all over the
Okay,
place.
that's very strange.
Also, can we get him to get the log? If I click, sometimes it will. No, didn't convince him. Because if I click, it'll show up on his screen as that blue floating thing. There we go. Oh, maybe.
Okay.
I wonder if that's usually what happens to him, and that's why he doesn't play with the log.
He's explaining.
Yeah. That is weird.
Yeah, I know he was having some trouble getting a client to work at all. So, you know. Hey, look.
Oh,
We
there
saw
it
the
is.
game
Oh,
log.
there it is.
Okay. So Deidre has, I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. He's got two mountebanks and two lighthouses and the hunting party. And Hugo's got this oracle. So like 5-2 in a mountebank game, that's a big deal. We expect him to be ahead, and he certainly is.
Yeah.
How many? I think Hugo has both of the purples. Or does? I didn't check to see which deck the second one went into. Can you explain the rules to Dominion Survival? So right now we're in the second Swiss stage. We play some games, and then whoever has the highest, you know, 8 scores, we'll move on to the next stage of it. So right now we're in the after this round of 2 games, we're gonna have everyone play 2 more games until you want to get as many points as you can from match wins to try and get into the top 8. That's the short version of it. A
Which
win
is,
for either one of these people would help them quite a lot because it's worth a lot of points.
yeah, and especially these ones are the ones from this Swiss round are worth twice as much as the last one, so.
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and check the current score of the tournament to see where these guys stand.
Pretty sure Hugo just won a match.
Yeah, so Hugo's got 9 points with the only match he has left to play. If he wins this, he's almost surely in the top 8. If he ties it, he probably will still be in the top 8.
We still have two more after this, though, right? Before cuts are made.
Yeah, that's true. That would be, yeah. Things can change after that. I shouldn't. Okay.
Yeah.
Very smart.
Let's hope, because I'm currently not in the top eight, so.
So I think Hugo got he got one lighthouse, is that right?
I don't know. I've still been messing with
Outwit,
Twitch.
outlast,
Not
outpost. I don't know that there's a motto for Dominion Survival, but you know, we could I'm sure there are I'm sure suggestions are welcome in my book. So it appears that Hugo has two mountebanks and an oracle. Think he has the fortress as well. He's also fairly junked, but save can be useful. Like I would expect him to save, like play his mountebank, and then save the oracle for next turn, and then get a hunting party. That seems reasonable, especially his opponent isn't going to be covered. Ah, the hosting is now working.
Yes, the hosting is now working, but I need to figure out how to stop Twitch again. I had it set up so that it wouldn't play plugins on Twitch, just so that when I'm streaming myself, I don't hear myself.
Right.
But I can just mute it. Okay, now everything is right in the world.
Okay, very good. So, how do you feel about prints on this board?
So prints, I don't know, I mean you could print spy to like make a village, but I mean there's just not good prints targets.
Yeah, the best one I can see is Oracle.
Yeah, an oracle would be a pretty good prince target, but I don't. I mean, I'd imagine with all the mountebank crap going around that you wouldn't have many good opportunities to get up to eight.
Yeah, I would say if you prince an oracle, you've probably already won the game.
Yeah.
Either that, or you should be getting green.
Yeah. Exactly. I think the I don't think that you'll have the free turn to skip province to get prince.
It kind of depends on how the junks go and how good your coverage is. Like, if I get a lot of hunting parties, I'm going to want to pile those grand markets and build, and maybe conspirators, and build for a little bit longer than normal.
Yeah.
So maybe a prince fits in there somewhere. Also, hunting party does help you find prince and the target that you want. So that's a thing.
That's true. And I guess also hunting party, I mean, hunting party is just great draw anyway.
Oh, save even helps too. I didn't even think about that. Yeah, there is a lot of support for it, but really Oracle is the only target. And like, I don't think I want an Oracle in the deck unless I'm going to prince it.
Yeah, exactly. I think I would have had a different opening here on 4/3.
Yeah, for sure.
I think I maybe would have. Well, I mean, I definitely would have opened with a lighthouse. And then probably with silver.
I mean, I might have, like, traveling fair at a lighthouse and, like, traveling fair at another lighthouse. Like, seeing a 5/2 opening from my opponent, I probably would have just gone all the way in for, like, all lighthouses and top decking and stuff for a long time.
So he's going to hit 8.
Infinite Hitbox asks a very good question. I will answer that question.
So I realize that now I have to be, even though I'm hosting you, I need to be on my own, or be on yours, so that I can reply to anything in the chat.
Yeah. There we go. There's the match score. Also, what the heck is with the screen? Making fun is with the screen. That is the answer to your question.
Oh, so it's... So the screen looks different on your stream than it does on...
Oh, really?
Yeah, so right, we just get this nice little... I don't even know what color that is.
Like...
Orange, baby, brown.
Baby poop. Orange.
Oh, okay, never mind. It's just that your stream is that far behind.
We get rainbow colors for the background. I mean, this is a quality product, guys.
Yeah.
Quality product.
It's a different... I do like the different... It keeps the background exciting.
Yeah, like, people were saying, like, hey, this background is really boring. Why don't you guys do something about it? And so, like, here you are. It's an interactive background.
Yeah, they went for the... You know how they have, like, the different times of day, they have different backgrounds?
Ooh, yeah.
They just went all out and went for disco clown backgrounds.
Like, when it's your action phase and you have 2 actions left, then you get a certain background. And, like, while you're playing a card, like, there's a background for that. And then it changes.
Exactly.
It's super good.
It's Dekrieg, by the way, that's commentating.
Yeah, hi. How are you?
In the hitbox that's asking.
What's up? Have a good day today?
Yeah, it was a pretty good day. So I'm actually starting my PhD.
Oh, snap.
In computer science.
So you're going to be much smarter than I am.
No, I'll just do different kinds of programming than you will.
We'll just say you're much smarter than I am. I have a PhD. I don't. You win. GG.
Oh. So, anyway, so I'm just starting to do the research for that, and I started on Monday, so it's been nice.
Yeah, I tried research. I didn't like it, so then I didn't get a PhD.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's pretty much what a PhD is, so...
Yeah. So, Deidre has the one grand market out there, and I'm not positive of what the hunting party split is, but I think it's fairly even. There's also this gold in the world. Would be nice to know who has that gold.
Well, now Deidre at least has... Oh, don't... I would have played the...
He wants to find his other mountebank because his opponent doesn't have coverage out, so he played the mountebank first. It makes sense. I like the play.
Yeah. I didn't see. I thought the curses were out.
Oh yeah. Well, I figured... I would still do it, because that mountebank is one of the best ways you have of hitting Grand Market too.
Yeah. Well, so here's a Grand Market.
Yeah, this is pretty fortunate. I think there's just the one lighthouse out. No save copper shenanigans.
Yeah. One thing I do not like about the newest release is that they stack your cards on your mat.
Hmm. I have not noticed that.
So, like, if you have, like, five caravans out, they'll stack them on top of each other, whereas before they would, split them up so that you could actually count without clicking on your mat.
Hmm. Okay. That's interesting. Deidre has just bought a duchy. I feel like that should be talked about. So, like, the purples are almost out, lighthouses are low, and the only plus buy is traveling fair, but there's Grand Market. There's that one Grand Market that Deidre has. So, like, he's prioritizing points quite a bit here. It also seems that he, like, delayed that lighthouse coverage, and I think he's losing the curse split.
So yeah.
That's, like, another thing.
So I think Deidre just got unlucky, because I believe he was the one with all the lighthouses at the beginning.
I think he delayed them. Or wait, no, he wasn't. No, you're right.
No, that was Hugo that delayed them.
Hmm. I wonder what happened then. That's strange.
Yeah, I don't know if I like that duchy. I mean, it'll cost you quite a bit to use traveling fair to pile out the lighthouses.
Yeah, I can't imagine Hugo's actually threatening a pile out. The duchy, like, what else do you want on five if you're not getting duchy? Like, I mean, I would get a conspirator even. He's already playing tons of actions each turn.
Yeah.
He's got a good stack of hunting parties in his deck.
Yeah, it definitely looks like Deidre has the better deck as of right now.
He's got, like, more good cards, but more bad cards, I think.
Mm-hmm.
He's got, like, a couple more curses.
But it looks like he has more hunting parties,
yeah,
which are able to skip all those.
Yeah, I didn't catch how the split went, but I think it was fairly close. But yeah, hunting parties is a really good card in this game.
Especially in a mountebank slog.
I feel like this one didn't have to be a slog. I feel like there are tools to get good enough lighthouse coverage.
Yeah.
So, Deidre has that province as well. I do quite like the province. He's got some good cards, and there is a real threat of a pile out here. A couple of Grand Markets, and I could see him getting aggressive and lowering those lighthouses if he wants to.
Yeah, until this happens.
Yeah, this is a big turn.
Yeah.
Hugo's found his one Grand Market. What does he have? He's got 14 and two buys. It doesn't look like there's a win here, but he can score a lot of points.
Yeah. Although I don't know if he wants to. I don't know. I don't think that the piles are low enough to try to really go hard on points.
I don't know. I feel like falling too far behind in points could be pretty bad. Like, I like province and a good card here.
Mm-hmm.
Like, maybe save a copper and province conspirator.
Mm-hmm. Or even top deck the conspirator.
Yeah. I mean, he's only played... This started from a clean shuffle. Yeah, this hand started from a clean shuffle. He's only played two hunting parties, so if he believes he's got, like, a lot of hunting parties in there, which he does, top decking conspirator could be quite good, too. Yeah, that's probably better. Probably better than saving a copper.
Yeah. Ooh, and he's going to top deck something. Maybe not. I mean, if he buys traveling fair now, it's so that he can top deck a Grand Market. which seems not right.
Well, I like...
Okay, I do like the saving the copper smart.
Yeah, saving a curse for a mountebank defense, since he doesn't have a lighthouse out, is pretty good.
Yeah.
Although, man, he's getting behind in points. Like, if his opponent has a big turn, it could be a little nasty. Although, if that Grand Market was a conspirator, this hand would be quite sad.
Yeah.
I'm trying to track the number of hunting parties that Hugo is seeing this shuffle.
It looks like Deidre has a lot more.
Yeah, well, we'll know very shortly. I've only seen 3 this shuffle, and there's 5 cards left. So either this was a very bad draw for Hugo, or Hugo had a really good draw
yeah.
for that big hand, and his deck is just really bad.
Yeah. So, on 7, what do you do?
Well, I think you definitely save a curse. Well, no, that doesn't matter. Well, it misses a shuffle. You save something, right?
Yeah, you definitely save something. I'd save the curse over the estate.
You could maybe save the curse next hand if you don't find a lighthouse. That's reasonable. Yeah, so only 3 hunting parties in the deck.
Yeah. With only 3 hunting parties in the deck, I'd be going... I don't know. That's kind of just rough.
Yeah, with 7 hunting parties and a lead, it's tough for me to see how Deidre wins this one. I've said his name like 4 different ways so far. I feel like a terrible person.
You mean to see how Hugo wins this one? Right, Hugo's the one with only 3
hunting
parties.
I think Hugo is going to have a tough time winning this one. That's what I'm trying to say. Words are hard, as you may know.
I think maybe I would go for the prince now, as Hugo, just as like a last ditch effort to get something going.
You think? Because I feel like Hugo should have started getting provinces a little bit ago. If he falls too far behind in points, his situation is just dangerous.
Well, I think he's going to be pretty far behind anyway. So I think maybe go for... Right, because like, you're never going to catch up to somebody who has 7 hunting parties and the same amount of grand markets and pretty much everything else as you.
I would think one of the best ways to catch up is to green a little earlier. Try and... I mean, you can build on this board, right? If Hugo doesn't put pressure on his opponent to, like, make his deck worse, his opponent can get more Grand Markets and Conspirators, and he can really have
sense.
A much better deck. So, like, maybe Deidre should have built a little more. I mean, he had an early duchy that was a little weird. Maybe it could have been a Conspirator or something.
Yeah, that's true. I think Deidre should be building more. That's true. I guess I think Deidre should be building more, and that Hugo should be... here's the win.
Yeah, it looks like he has it.
No, he doesn't. He only has 3 buys. Oh, but he has... Yeah, no, he doesn't quite have it, does he?
Yeah, so I think I would get the lighthouses and leave the curses. And then hope Hugo duds. Either that or maybe top deck something good, although I don't know. Did he have enough money to get a province this turn? He did. I would have just gotten the province.
Yeah.
Without a force win.
Oh, he has a message coming in. Oh. Must have miscounted.
Oops.
How much lighthouses cost. He's probably waiting for Hugo to respond.
All right, I'll poke Hugo.
Well, you can just click on his screen.
Oh, it totally works, right? Okay. Yeah, miscounted.
Yeah. Ooh.
Panic estates.
I don't like the estates.
The Panic Estates.
I think I would have still emptied the lighthouses.
Man, it's tough. Like, you could maybe go one lighthouse, one estate. Seems okay.
Yeah.
Oh man, this is a big turn for Hugo again. He found four hunting parties, so that's a thing that he has in his deck.
One more than we thought he had.
Yeah, and this curse goes through.
Ooh.
Maybe those estates are going to turn out to be clutch.
Yeah.
So he's got 16 and two buys. What does it take for him to win? Well, he needs a lot of points, so I don't think.
He needs 13 for points, and then he needs the 4 for the lighthouses, and then the stuff for the extra buys.
This is about as good of a turn as Hugo could hope for, and the estates aren't mattering in this case. So yeah, I guess the estates are. I mean, if he'd gotten lighthouses, yeah, Hugo still couldn't win.
Yeah, I think I agree with double province there.
Wait a second. If Deidre had got lighthouses and not estates, then duchy curse would have won for Hugo. So yeah, I guess the estates did matter.
Yeah. Yeah, so I think getting all of his hunting parties was the only way that could have happened.
Yeah, it's I think you can assume that this hand, if you're Deidre, I think you can assume that this hand from Hugo is not going to be very good.
Yeah, which we can see that it's not going to be all that great.
So there's a panic duchy. If Hugo can scrape together $6, which he can't, he could potentially take a tie.
Yeah, so what do you do here? Do you...
I think you save copper and buy an estate.
Yeah, oh, duh. Yeah, I think this is the point when Hugo is sad.
A miracle draw is possible here.
But he has to hope that Deidre has no miracle.
It's true. I would still favor Deidre here, but it's not over. Things can happen.
Oh. 4 is not enough to do much.
Is there any treasure in that hand?
Wow, now we get black background.
Yeah, it's evening time. The piles are low, so.
Let's see, where does Hugo live?
Well, I mean, I was saying, like, it's evening time in the game. Like, you know how the picture starts off in the morning and then, like, as the game is ending, the background picture turns into this night scene.
Oh, is that what happens?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it actually depended on time of day.
Oh, yeah. I think since the Goku days, like it did that. Uh-oh, 9.
Huh.
So saving a province. I like
the
play.
He really couldn't have finished it there. I guess he couldn't have.
Yeah, he needed 2 traveling fares to get the buys.
Yeah.
So then there wasn't enough money left over to get points. Oh man, Hugo can match with a province here.
Yeah. Which I think he should.
Yep. I agree. And save a purple.
Because
that
even
matters.
Need to save a purple, though.
I mean, hunting party could skip it next turn. It's certainly better than not doing it. Even if the gain coppers don't matter. Oh boy.
Well, this is looking good.
That's a dangerous hand.
Yeah. Ooh.
Well, he found a grand market.
I guess that was good to skip all of those lighthouses.
So, like, he wants to hit province here. That's the easiest way for him to end the game.
Yeah.
Although, with a grand market, if he gets another buy, he could do it with 6 and... or no, never mind. Province is still easiest.
9, yeah. He must not be there, because he's not just winning.
I think he's got it.
He's just slow playing for the effect.
Maybe he's counting. Counting is hard.
That's very true. No, I don't think he has it.
You see, it's a knight scene. There we go.
Oh, yeah. So this could be a win.
Yeah, this is a dangerous hand. Oh yeah, boy.
There we go.
That's GG right there.
Yeah, easy.
So Hugo had a couple of fortunate turns. And it seems he built the appropriate amount of time. So that's a thing that happened.
Yeah. Well, there you go. So this is one thing that I always love about Dominion, is that even once you have enough points to win, you still buy out all of the points that you can.
Well, yeah. What if you miscounted?
Well, I mean, there's a victory point counter, and it just cracks me up at the time.
But what if you miscounted? Addition is hard, man.
But I just love it when it's like, when you're up by like 5 colonies, and you still like buy out all of the, you know, all of the provinces after that. And...
yeah, it's good for him. So that's a thing that happened. Let's begin another exciting game of Dominion here. Come on, Kingdom, go.
Okay. So we get a nice purple.
Alright, rebuilding colonies.
Rebuild.
Knights on a colony board means next to nothing. Oh, and here's a very helpful display. Yeah. Oh.
Nope, gone.
So there's only tactician for village. It's also really the only draw, but storyteller can work.
Yeah, storyteller works if you have like a money gainer.
It doesn't seem to be that many terminals you really want to play.
I guess that's true.
Hitbox says, "Well, Dame Molly is on top. That's a village." Well, yeah. If she's any good, she'll die quickly, right?
Yeah.
So like, rebuild's a really good card, and like platinum looks like the payload, and plus buy is a little hard to come by, but like maybe pillage is enough to stop rebuild.
I don't think so. I think I'd just go for rebuild.
I don't know, like recently on principle, like I've just been trying to ignore rebuild, and I've been having more success than I thought I would.
Yeah,
even in a competitive match I would probably try and ignore rebuild, and Hugo opens salvager. That is not consistent with rebuild.
Yeah, that is definitely a rebuild. Ooh. His opponent starts 5-2 again.
Uh-oh. Yeah, that's not going to be good. And that scouting party?
Yeah.
On the 2 for a second turn, like that's quite good. He can make sure he plays that rebuild turn 3. And get going immediately. I mean, he's going to need some economy at some point, especially like given that Hugo is signaling that he does not want to go for rebuild. He will want lots of rebuilds, and he's going to need silvers to buy. Or rebuild and tunnel, even. Yeah, that doesn't seem very good on the colony board.
No. I mean, I think it'll be fine, though. I just don't think the engine is strong enough here to really skip rebuild.
Yeah, what is the draw? Like, storyteller can work, but, like, the treasures are your payload, and if they're also your draw, that's just never really a very good deck.
Yeah, well, and you have to... I mean, there's no way to, like... Right? If you have, like, Soothsayer or something that can gain you a bunch of golds to draw with storyteller, that's nice, but, I mean, you really need something that gains you non-coppers for Storyteller to really be good draw.
Upgrade gains silvers when you trash estates.
That's true.
Yeah.
That's
pretty
but,
good.
I mean, that's still not that many.
Well, I mean, you just want everything,
ooh,
don't you? So are we pivoting into Tunnel? Maybe he opened Salvager and wanted to go into Rebuild? Maybe he wants to go into a focused Rebuild Tunnel for gold gaining with Salvager.
Yeah. I mean, I guess if you get, like, three tunnels and then just skip them all the time with Rebuild.
Right. I mean, you can gain a lot of golds that way.
Still doesn't seem very good.
I would agree. I mean, Scouting Party and Rebuild
party does help.
Both enable the tunnels. But, like, if you want Rebuild, usually you don't want other things. And if you want...
Yeah.
If you don't want Rebuild, then... I mean, golds on a colony board aren't the greatest thing ever.
I think I'd go Duchy there.
The gaining tunnels with the Rebuild?
Yeah.
I think it's fine. I mean, once you want to make it so all of the green cards in your deck are tunnels, and play like one or two Rebuilds to flood with gold.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense.
I think there's time enough on the board with the colonies that's probably worth it because you can pick up some more Rebuilds.
Yeah, I guess I don't think I've ever played Rebuild Tunnel.
JSH says Storyteller Tunnel looks good as a payload.
Oh, yeah.
So can you target discard the tunnel from your hand? You can discard it with Rebuild, you can discard it with Scouting Party, but like not in your buy phase. Or action phase. You know. Actions,
mm-hmm.
buys, same thing. You must be a hit at baby showers. The wife likes the cat. They heard you talking to the cat. She has justified this by saying that the cat is adorable.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I guess
I'm not gonna say the F word on stream. My mom could be watching this.
I will not be surprised.
Okay, do you wanna say it into the microphone? She does not want to say the F word into the microphone. Okay, there it is. You heard it here first, everyone. We just bumped up the rating of this stream to like PG-13. She said one of the seven words.
So that play right there was a little interesting to me. So he had four, but he only played the gold and then bought one Scouting Party. When Scouting Party gives you an extra buy, right? So you can
mm-hmm.
just keep going for it.
Sure. Was there a shuffle he didn't want to trigger? I was paying attention to my wife swearing. I'm sorry.
I don't know, because he would have just discarded three more cards, and so he would have had one card left on his deck instead of...
Deidre has bought Scouting Party, and he successfully discarded three tunnels with it.
Oh, there we go. He just figured out
okay.
the...
So, like, Rebuild is good. Oh, that was for us, yeah.
That was for us.
Rebuild has, Rebuild's good, but, like, it looks like they only are using it as a gold gainer and want to play something more money-ish. Is that it?
But he has so many of them.
They each have two, right?
I thought Hugo had three.
Hmm.
But
then
I'm
maybe
probably
I was
wrong about that.
I might be describing Deidre's strategy. I mean, I get it. Scouting Party enables tunnels too, though, and is quite good.
Yeah. Well, and I feel like you are fine just going with, like, ooh. Yeah, I don't like this whole gold gaining thing now.
Golds are fine, but like colonies, you know, golds are fine for it, but gold flood just isn't as good on a colony board.
Yeah.
You do have to go through a good amount of trouble if you're gonna go for rebuilds.
Well, and like neither of them are using rebuild as, you know, rebuild.
I think Deidre might have transitioned into that. Yeah, I think Deidre has transitioned into that.
So
He
like
didn't
here, I
start
don't
that
think I'd
way.
go scouting party. I think I'd go either platinum or province.
With three rebuilds in the deck, the province gets a little more attractive, I think.
Can't see
Uh-oh.
us anymore.
Oh, did the cat chew on this plastic animal and break its leg? Chewed its hoof off there. I mean, whether or not we should blame it on the cat, regardless, right?
Oh yeah, so Deidre just trashed a tunnel with rebuild, so he's definitely transitioned.
I think that's the second tunnel that he's trashed.
Is it?
I'm not positive, but I think it is.
Could be. I can't check the trash, so.
Yeah, you know, when half of the features work, it gets more difficult.
Yes. Yeah, I wonder if Hugo can check the trash.
He
Yeah,
probably
so I
can.
think the Salvager is a good choice here.
Yeah, I mean, one of the reasons I think that you actually want gold in the deck is because of Salvager.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I would at some point decide, okay, it's time to stop gaining golds and make my deck better. But like Salvager, sure, give me all the golds.
Yeah. So I'd maybe even pick up a second Salvager here. Just by what his strategy seems to be, which is just like totally flood your deck with golds as much as possible.
So Deidre here is he's going for more of the points. Piles could start to be in danger pretty soon here. There are two rebuilds left, and I could legitimately see them emptying.
Yeah, so Hugo now has 14 golds.
That's a lot of golds, man.
That seems like it's time to do something else. Oh, he does too.
JSH has announced his allegiance to Deidre for this match because apparently it helps him. All right.
Oh, that JSH.
Whatever, man.
He does that every match though.
He's usually rooting against me when he roots for someone when I'm playing,
Yes,
which
same for me,
I mean,
so.
it's easy to root against me. There are plenty of reasons out there why you would want to. So like, you can take your pick and choose your favorite. So it's okay.
JSH is just trying to take out all of the. He wants all of the highly seeded players gone, so. Understandably so.
You know what? If everyone loses, then nobody loses.
Well,
That makes
except
sense.
it can't be that everybody loses.
Well, you know, I mean, if everyone wins, then nobody wins. So if everyone loses, then nobody loses either. Yeah, the gold pile is also low, so like this lead that Deidre has could be significant. He also seems to have a way to like get I mean, he has a way to get more points, but like, actually, I don't think Deidre has much control over the piles. Like, Duchy is one
No,
piles, but like, I mean, if he's got five here, sure, go for the rebuild, and then I say start milling duchies. Like, name
yeah.
colony, I think he's got two of them, and then just mill duchies.
I agree and hope that I mean I'd oh he has two colonies.
I think
Okay.
he's got both of them.
I was gonna say if he only had one of them, then maybe name tunnel and go for the gold as the last pile out.
Sure.
I mean that I mean, I guess this that works with scouting party two.
Whenever I'd there's a tie, no one ties.
I'd go another scouting party over a an estate.
Yeah, so Hugo has stopped revealing his tunnels for golds, which is smart. JSH says, I don't like Adam because he's so much cuter than me. I disagree. Thank you.
I'd pick up a relic here, maybe. Or maybe Storyteller. Oh, Storyteller would be pretty good. More scouting parties.
What about, like... What about a knight?
Ooh.
I don't know. It all just seems really bad.
I'd go Storyteller for sure here. I mean, now that your deck is... I mean, I think he has 15 golds.
That's a lot of golds. 14
golds or something.
Yeah. Okay. Sure. That's probably better than anything else he could get.
Especially a state. Well, here's a colony for him.
All right, this could be... I mean, if this could be what he needs. Especially if Deidre decides to mill a duchy here, which, I mean, that lead is a little tenuous, so I don't know if I would do that.
Oh. Yeah, this is a little bit more interesting than I thought it was going to be. I mean, surely you get scouting party before you... by province there, or by colony there, but... Oh, looks like he's gonna pile out this turn.
Yeah, that's, Yeah, it's gonna do it. He's got it. Well, there it goes. Another exciting edition of Rebuild is broken.
Yes.
Let's move on with our lives, yeah.
I don't know. I think I would have gone for some more storytellers. Because you can just feed Storyteller 3 golds and draw, you know, a ton of cards.
Yeah, I certainly think Storyteller has got to be better than like Rebuild number 4 for somebody. So.
Yeah.
What's going on here? Some stuff. There's not really draw, except for Embassy.
Embassy, which kind of works.
I guess you can increase your hand size with Duration, Fishing Village, and Embassy. That seems pretty sad. Yeah. Bridge Troll is a payload. Oh, man. I just don't really think that can cut it. There's also no copper trashing.
Yeah,
I think I might play Embassy with Fishville and Horde.
Yeah, that sounds good. I'd maybe throw in a Hamlet.
I'd probably open Transmogrify. Mm-hmm. You can, if things are going well for you, if you feel like you're drawing a lot, if you end up getting a lot of Embassies, yeah, sure. Ooh. Transmogrify into a Hamlet, that's pretty good.
Maybe just do Ferry on Embassy.
As second player, I'd like that a lot. As first player, I would feel much less good about it. Like, a double Fishing Village opening seems just fine if you don't want to shuffle in a silver for your opponent.
Hmm. I don't know if I'd... I mean, I guess Bridge Troll works to just go crazy for because of... Like, there are a lot of cheap things that are fun to buy.
Counting House and Embassy can increase hand size. That is...
That's true.
Really something. Do you think it can work?
I mean... Yeah, but I think it takes just... too much to put together. I don't know.
Two stacks of villages? Hamlet can... Hamlet's not that great. It's a consolation prize for Fishing Village. But, I mean, you will need a second stack of villages to make that deck work. I'm really surprised that I mean, they're going very heavy for Bridge Troll, but neither one of them has gotten a Transmogrify. Transmogrify is going to be really helpful for, like, gaining Fishvilles and preventing hands like this from being awful.
Yeah. I don't know if I'd go so hard on Hamlet.
I'd go a lot more
into Fishing Village.
Hamlet's better than nothing, but, man, it just doesn't feel good to have it, you know?
Oh, I see. He had a minus one token. That's why he did it this last turn.
JSH says the problem with Embassy Big Money is you often hit exactly eight. So, like, yeah, you build a little more. You stick Hordes and Fishvilles in the deck, yeah? I mean, that makes sense to me. They are both...
I think with Hordes, Embassy Big Money just goes, like, just way better than Bridge Troll.
I can't help but think that Embassy Big Money is going to beat whatever they're doing here. But this game will not serve to be an example to that because components are contested. So both their decks are going to be weaker than normal. So it's not a valid comparison.
Well, I mean, they're contested only kind of in the sense that, like, right, you'd still be contesting Fishing Villages with Embassy Big Money. And you're not going to want... I mean, I don't think they're going to get to play more than five Bridge Trolls.
I guess. Sure, that's reasonable.
And we can't see what turn they're at anyway, so... can't figure out how far into the game they are. I think here I'd move my fairy token.
To Embassy?
Yeah.
Yeah, Embassy is something that they could use, although, like, I think you probably want to get your first Embassy before the Bridge Trolls are gone. I think that's a little better for building the deck.
Yeah, well, and it'd be cool, it'd be fun here to put Fairy on Embassy and then upgrade your estates into Embassies.
You know,
a party.
I said there was no copper trashing, but Bridge Troll plus Transmogrify can actually turn your coppers into Vagrants. So, like, alright, you got me on that one.
I can, and if you get two Bridge Trolls, you can turn your coppers into Fishing Villages.
It's true.
Yeah, I totally agree with that, except for the Hamlet over the Fishing Village.
So next time we get to see the game log, turn 8. Wow.
Okay, so I guess... Well, I mean, I guess this is going to end early because of piles, not because of points running out. Yeah, so piles are going to go, like, in a couple of turns, I would think.
The game is basically over.
Yeah.
Seems difficult for either one of them to get more... play more than one Bridge Troll in a turn. I think it's just... this will probably come down to who connects first.
Yeah. I'd go Oh, he can't go Transmogrify here.
The sadness of that minus $1 token.
Yeah. I don't know, maybe Vagrants. I don't like him looking at estates.
I mean, you really want better cards in your deck than estates.
Yeah. Well, and I mean, like, right, all the other player needs to do is get a duchy with their... Oh, this is a great hand for him, though.
Well, it's got potential.
The ominous floating estate.
Look at me, I've got a point, dude.
Oh, you can even click on it. I didn't know you could click on it.
Oh, yeah.
So it, like, knows that it's there.
Huh. Oh, yeah. That estate is legit in the middle of the play area.
It'll count for Grand Castle, or whichever castle it is that gets you points.
So, like, this turn does have potential, although, you know, he still can't have more than five cards in his hand from it. So, yeah. Like, just getting Fishvilles and in play and then, like, trying to find enough bridge trolls. Like, yeah, I would just... I would keep... yeah, exactly what he's kept here. And just play those three bridge trolls and then, yep. like, hope my opponent can't pile out next turn. Next turn should be great.
Yeah, I would grab some embassies here.
Yeah, you want some draw. Embassies, what's going to make you be able to win the game. Hugo has misclicked and discarded Bridge Troll for a buy. That's really bad.
Yeah, I hate Hamlet sometimes. Because that happens to me all the time.
I said he had the win. He had three bridge trolls in play, but he had nothing else in play, and he would have had $3
to buy anything.
He had five gains.
Five
estates, but that's still only two piles. I don't see how he wins.
Yeah, I don't think so. Right, you need at least six. You need seven buys to win.
Actually, he only would have had four buys.
Yeah, he needed a lot more buys.
Yeah, okay, so I think he's just thinking there was another pile empty, and he could get the estates. Or no, he couldn't get the estates. I don't know what he was thinking. Anyway.
He must have thought there was another pile gone.
He could have gotten, like, two duchies and two hamlets or something if there was another pile empty, I guess.
Yeah, or just bought out the estates. Although he still would have only had four buys.
Yeah, with only four buys, the estates don't work. So, like, the line of play is pretty similar. Although he can... Actually, he can only still only get one embassy.
Probably all he wanted. I think I'd still go for it.
Yeah, I think he really wants the embassy over the duchy here. Like, he can't take a lead. Well, okay, he can take a lead, but then his deck is awful, so, like... That's not a winning play, I don't think.
Then just three vagrants, I guess. Why not?
I mean, it's a pile.
This is still good.
This is a great hand for Hugo, though. He did find an embassy, and he's got two bridge trolls in hand. So, like, there is still hope. He could legitimately win it on this turn. Knowing that, Deidre probably wants to... Well, either end it this turn, which seems ambitious, or get some green. I think he's in rough shape. He's only got that one embassy. How many bridge trolls can he get in play?
Yeah, I think this... I mean, if Hugo had three... Okay, I definitely take the province here.
Yeah, I think province is important.
That's... your only play.
Vagrant can increase hand size. There you go. We did it, guys. We did it.
Jeez, Adam, why do you keep telling people that there's no way to increase hand size on this board? There are so many ways.
Hey, I said duration Fishville plus embassy did it. That was not false.
Okay, this is looking good.
Yeah, it's a little sad he didn't find a third bridge troll. Just to get it in hand and then just play the bridge trolls, but this is still a-okay.
Well, I think I'd discard the hamlet. No.
I think he's trying to reach for a third bridge troll. I think that's what he wants. There's another bridge troll in those last few cards. I think he's got five of them. If he draws that bridge troll and manages to play it, he'll be in really good shape. Might be able to find a win, but yeah, that didn't happen.
Yeah. So I guess you pick up the extra buy here. Just for funsies.
Alright, can Hugo win from here?
No, he cannot.
Right, he can't win.
Oh.
Is he going to go aggro on the estate?
He doesn't know.
He must have thought that was the last pile.
Oh, that hurts.
Okay.
Yeah.
There we go. Okay. Well, his line of play makes sense assuming that was the third pile. Although Deidre would have missed several forced wins by this point.
Yes.
So yeah, the estates are certainly aggressive. If duchies were free or cheap, probably would have been a good play. He had some duration bridge trolls, and that might have been the maximum points, actually. He's going for duchies with all that cost reduction.
Yeah, so I mean, obviously he didn't know that that wasn't the third pile.
Hugo's in a little bit of trouble if Deidre has a good hand, but...
Yeah, so now he's realizing that he did not have the win with buying out estates last time either. Right. So Deidre just needs to get a province with a couple extra buys.
That's going to be tough, though. He only had one Fishville and a Duration Bridge Troll. So yeah, he only gets two of them in play this turn. I don't think he can... Wait, can he win? Does he have any money? He's got...
Yeah, if he has four, but he only has two cards, so...
Yeah, that's not going to happen.
Yeah. Which is good for... Hugo.
Yeah, Hugo's, I mean, Deidre can't even take a lead here, and that means it's gonna...
Because there's no estates.
Yeah, so, like, Hugo can just win the game at the start of his turn, right? He's got two duration bridge trolls, so that's GG.
Yeah. So he must only have three.
$1 short. If he had $2, I don't think he could still win, right?
No. Well, he must have a silver in his hand.
Okay, sure. Yeah, it takes $4 to win. He needs two duchies.
Yeah.
So, hey, maybe the estates were the right choice here. Well, no, because if he didn't get any estates, there wouldn't be the gains. So, yeah. That was it. So I think the difference in this game was that Hugo went a little harder for the draw, and so he was able to put together some bigger turns. So, like, I really think that's what won in the game.
Yeah, I think that they each should have even gotten more of those now.
Yeah, like, instead of piling bridge trolls right away, you might have wanted to, like, get some Fishvilles in there, get some embassies, start cycling. Transmogrify, I feel like, would have been great.
Well, especially with Bridge Troll. I mean, when you can switch a copper into, or an estate into Embassy. You had Bridge Troll and Ferry. Yeah.
Oh, snap. Yeah. You can do some pretty ridiculous things.
Yeah.
All right. Last game and Ambassador. This could be gross. Oh, good. Good. We were saved from something that could have been terrible. Mort,
you don't like watching Ambassador slogs?
I mean, the draw looked pretty terrible on that one, but there was goons, so, like, that game could have taken an hour.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't look at it, but I saw Ambassador goons and, like, Ranger crossroads for draw. It did not look fun. Well, okay, depends so on your definition of fun.
The land of the expensive cards.
So the event was trade. What's the deal here? Thinning is it's tough to do. Drawing cards is tough to do. There's actually no draw here.
No, not
at
all.
Can't increase your hand size. Not even with crazy tricks, right? I'm not seeing any crazy tricks.
No. Well, yeah, I mean, Mystic obviously doesn't increase hand size, but you can... that doesn't even... Yeah, so I think this is just, like, maybe Fool's Gold?
I like Fool's Gold. I like trade. Fool's Gold helps you trade.
Yeah.
I guess Expand doesn't seem that hot, unless you could open with it. Wine Merchant Fool's Gold's a fine opening.
It's a great opening.
A little better than double fool's gold. Yeah.
You really? I mean, he has gotten 5-2 three of the four rounds.
Yamyosil, man. He makes so much shuffle luck.
Yeah.
I think farmland could potentially be very important this game. Like, if you have six and a copper in hand, like, farmland copper into fool's gold is very strong.
Yeah.
Also, it gives you a little more of incentive to react fool's gold. Slightly, but really not. I just don't see any cards other than farmland, fool's gold, and wine merchant, and, like, maybe trade playing at all here.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that trade will be really good when it hits.
Like, you get that hand of two fool's golds and a couple of estates, and, like, your deck is just way better.
What? Oh, so he just bought the wine merchant.
Hugo goes for a wine merchant with two fool's golds left. I mean, if his opponent doesn't double, that could be a decent play to do.
Still kind of risky, though, with the... I mean, his opponent did just shuffle, and so it's possible that he does have his wine merchant.
Yeah.
So he could pick up the last couple, but...
Doesn't seem like a huge deal to me. Yeah. JSH says, I don't know that I do fool's gold. Spy Mystic looks good. I want to play this board against you now. I don't think that's any good at all.
Especially with, like, the fool's gold just craziness that you can do. Like, I mean, if you get all of the fool's gold.
Yeah. This is one of those, like, you let your opponent have all the fool's gold, you're going to have a bad time.
Yeah.
So, like, what's better here? Do you get a province? Do you trade coppers into silvers? Do you get gold, expand, bank, farmland?
I think I'd trade here.
So trade, you think, is better than gold? I think I agree. Would have been a lot sexier if it was estates, but it wasn't.
Yeah. So here he can also trade, which I think you want to do.
Hitbox says, I like trading one time. I really like trading when you can get rid of estates.
Yeah.
The coppers isn't as valuable, but, like, even then, I think it's still probably better than the alternatives.
A potion?
Got a potion. I don't like the potion.
I don't like that.
Like, how many times can you play that possession before the game's over? And what are those hands going to look like? It just doesn't seem worth it.
I think I would still trade here.
Even though the wine merchant. You could just trade the one estate and get the wine merchant back, which appears to not be what he did. He bought a second wine merchant.
No, he got a potion as well.
Oh, he got a potion.
Yes. My thoughts in my head were exactly like that. He got a potion.
Okay. Well, they both bought it. It doesn't change my opinion. I don't think the potion's any good.
And I think I would have traded that fool's gold.
Yeah, I think I would have reacted it as well.
I guess trading is a bad verb to use right now for reacting.
Trading was not legal on that hand.
Yes, I would have reacted it as well.
Oh, game log. It's so good. Like, I really think he should get a province, but, I mean, obviously that's not going to happen.
Yeah.
Like, can we track and we can see, like, if that possession was a province, like, you know, it's a dead card, so that's no difference. So, like, we can just see what he gets out of that possession.
Yeah. So, right there, it was a province instead of possession. Although, I guess you could have even done, like, farmland, trash your potion, and get another farmland.
Hey, I think that would be a great play.
Yeah, so, definitely province and free him.
So, Deidre has once again gotten off to an early lead. This is actually pretty fortunate for Hugo to see all this. It means he's got some good stuff coming up. and his opponent doesn't have possession yet.
Oh, this would be a really bad time for his opponent. Oh, his opponent. Oh, I see.
Yeah.
I didn't see that his opponent hadn't even gotten possession yet.
So, like, if Hugo plays the possession here, I think it would be a clear mistake. I mean, it's a province hand. You can even, like, can't get your wine merchant back. That's fine though. Like,
Yeah.
do you really think you're possessing a province hand?
Yeah, I think so. Someone in the chat is saying that one thing about possession is that it makes you wonder if you want to pull your wine merchant off the mat. So I think that's true definitely when you have like possessing happening every turn.
Yeah, the only reason you would want to make your deck actually worse just because you're getting possessed is if your opponent's playing more turns with your deck than you are. That is never happening this game.
Yeah. I mean, it like literally cannot, so.
I don't know, man. Expand, thin down, bandit camp. They might be able to get two per turn reliably. Maybe.
I mean, I guess if you just
Lots
have
of
like a deck
sages.
full of spies.
Spies and sages.
Yeah. But I mean, like,
But your
nobody wants to
opponent will
build
have
that deck.
emptied provinces by that point, so yeah, that's not gonna happen.
Yeah.
Hugo played the possession, got the province, so it worked out for him. GJ.
Yeah.
Skip the province hand. I mean, possession swingy.
Yeah, well, especially in a fool's gold game.
Hugo's also been that first turn on this shuffle where he had like all of his bad cards, like he's doing pretty good here.
Yeah, that was definitely very fortunate for him.
Yeah, he'll be getting two provinces, and that's probably gonna be the difference. He skipped a province hand of his opponent's. Potion missed. That was fortunate for you.
Yeah. Don't know what you get here on. I guess we need to see
Yeah, if
Deidre's cards to
farmland
know.
could be pretty good. I like to think of farmland as a silver that can only be used to buy provinces.
Yeah.
So if you get good profitability off that remodel effect, like sticking the farmland in your deck, like that farmland's no longer a bad card.
Yeah.
It's like you gain a silver along with whatever you want, and if that's worth the extra business, you
Ooh.
know.
I would not have gone possession there at all.
So like Deidre's really feeling the pain of that potion. If the potion had been a silver, he'd be a lot happier with his life.
Yeah, I still think buying possession on the six potion hand this late in the game is a bad choice.
Could have done farmland potion into farmland. I think that would have been
Yeah.
pretty strong. Hugo also had a great last turn of the shuffle too. Right at the bottom, he manages to discard Wine Merchant, like so. Hugo, I feel like Hugo's in great shape here.
Yeah, no, I totally agree. I think this looks it's looking up for Hugo, especially if he grabs possession on a good turn for
Hey, Fool's Gold wouldn't have given him a province anyway. Would have given him like farmland or duchy, like. And
I
this
hope
is still
I was hoping he'd buy another sage.
this is I mean this is still a good draw for him. He's likely to hit province. He does it here. If
Yeah.
yeah, and I really think that most of this game came down to that possession hitting the province hand.
Yeah.
If that hadn't happened, we'd be it would be a different conversation right now. Like it would just be a province in Deidre's deck instead of Hugo's.
Yeah, exactly. That's true. I didn't think about it like that it's really a huge swing.
I think Hugo got a duchy that turn. He would have gotten a province instead, but look, or no, he didn't get anything. Okay, so it's a little more complicated, but you know.
Yeah. So Deidre has to go for the province here.
Unless he's gonna farmland something. I mean, he wants to gain a province, but farmland into duchy is not the play. Farmland into province might be the play. Double duchy.
I don't know. Oh. It's a good time to get that hand, I guess.
This was a really fortunate thing for Hugo to get.
Can leave his wine merchant high and dry.
So this is a nice farmland hand for Hugo. I think farmland potion into farmland is a very strong play.
Let's just hope that he doesn't play his play all treasures.
It puts him in great shape, though, because it means, first of all, the farmlands help him get one more province, and then with those points, he really just needs one more province to end the game.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, he does also technically have the potential maybe he doesn't, but to get 12. No, there's no way he gets 12 with two farmlands in hand. Never mind.
Yeah, so Deidre plays his potion here, and that doesn't feel good. He could have done farmland potion into farmland on that turn, just like Hugo's doing here. He had the same draw.
So what happens if you buy farmland while you're possessing another player? Do you get to... I guess you get to trash one of their cards and...
Yeah. I mean, the card's not gone forever, but you get the gainer. Yeah. It's pretty good. GG. It's pretty much impossible for Deidre to come back from this.
Yeah. I mean, he has to get farmland into duchy, a few times. I guess just go start buying estates. So this must be farmland into duchy.
So what does it take for Deidre to still win? He needs the province.
Seven.
Farmland potion. Farmland, discard wine merchant. It's pretty good.
So he now needs a duchy and a province to tie.
Yeah, and like farmland into province is... Yeah, it's still okay. Uh-oh.
Oh, man, that's just unlucky.
I mean, Deidre hasn't played his possession yet, so that legit should have been a province, and the potion should have been a silver in that case.
Yeah. So, he plays the other fool's gold... just buys duchy, right? If he buys duchy, I'm not sure if there are enough points on the board.
Yeah, I think the duchy's smart.
Duchy, he's up by 13, and on the board there's only... Oh, I guess there's still
there's
enough
19.
Points left.
Yeah.
But
he can get estates once he hits 50% VP, That'll be it.
I mean, I just go for estates even at this point.
Yep.
It looks like he's going to try to get the last province.
You do that, Hugo.
Which, I mean, it doesn't matter. He's got it at this point anyway.
Well, there's a hand.
Let's see. Farmland is exactly... So he can't get farmland and trash the possession and turn it into a province.
Sadly.
Then maybe... I mean, I guess his possession has been a good choice so far.
Oh, man, that feels so good. Get those two estates and skip that fool's gold like a boss.
Yeah,
but the two estates, that's going to do it. So that happened. well done to Hugo for winning the match.
Yeah.
It's going to be very helpful to him. I think that puts him temporarily in the top eight. So that's very good. Thank you for commentating with me. It's been a pleasure, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
And everyone who's watching, thanks for your witty commentary.
Yes.
Always.
Especially JSH, who had